fresh air. Good.
Well, good morning.
Good morning.
I get to do a welcome, and then they're going to make me sit down. And I would say just a welcome, but I want to mention something very special that's happening this week. And you'll hear it again in the announcements, and you'll have some people contacting you. There's a special seminar coming to Yarmouth. The church is sponsoring that to come. It would be a long trip for us to go to Moncton like they held it last year. It was a sold-out venture. They're holding it in Halifax. Every seat is taken. We still have some places available to go to Yarmouth because of where it is. And just like it would have been hard for us to travel to Moncton for the day and leave here at 3 o'clock in the morning and travel back after 5 o'clock, it's from 9:30 to 5 on Thursday, November the 1st. And it's about lay leadership, about people being involved in ministry in whatever way they can get involved and what that looks like. The concept is that in the early church, and in every great revival period over the centuries, they've discovered that it was because people who were, you might call them lay people, discovered that their place in ministry was to minister to the world around them with the talents and abilities that God gave them. And so the welcome here this morning is to welcome a group of people that might not normally lead a service. And I get to sit down. The more that we work together in ministry, the more people will hear the good news of the gospel on the boats, on the docks, in Tim Hortons, in homes, in the stores, wherever we go. And as we are going, we'll make disciples. And so I'm very, very thankful for the ladies of this church that are involved in missions work. And today, the ladies' mission is going to share more of what you guys do. And I'm going to learn. So as a good student, I'm going to sit down. But welcome to Westhead Wesleyan. I'm Pastor Vince, if you're here visiting today. This is a little bit of a special service and a little bit different than ordinary. But I trust that you'll be blessed. Each of us will be blessed by what we share and what we do. God bless you.
Can you hear me? Let's stand and we'll worship, singing, praising the Lord. We're together again, praising the Lord. We're together again, just praising the Lord. We're together. Together again, praising the Lord. We're together again, in one accord. Something good is going to happen. Something good is in store. We're together again, praising the Lord.
John 13:34-35 says, these are the words of Jesus. I give you a new commandment, that you love one another. Just as I have loved you, you also should love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another. And we're going to do a special medley this morning, so I hope you got your clapping hands ready.
This is my commandment, that you love one another, that your joy may be full. This is my commandment, that you love one another, that your joy may be full. That your joy may be full. That your joy. This is my commandment, that you love one another, that your joy may be full. opens prison's door, sets the captives free. I've got a river of life flowing out of me. Spring up, oh well, within my soul. Spring up, oh well, and make me whole. Spring up, oh well, and give to me that life abundantly. This is a day.
Can I ask you to open with prayer this morning, please? Now, I'll ask Lynne.
Maybe seated.
Maybe seated, though.
On behalf of the ladies, you here this morning, and you're going to have great time by getting up and shaking hands.
Yeah?
Yeah?
Yeah? Okay.
Yep. Kind of surprising. That's what they tell me.
Thank you.
love is shining in the midst of the darkness, shining. Jesus, light of the world, shine upon us, set us free by the truth you now bring us. Shine on me. Shine on me. Shine, Jesus, shine.
First, I'm going to have Eunice come up before we take up the offering.
Or down, as the case may be. Take a mic. Thank you. Since it's Pastor Appreciation Month, we have bought you guys a gift each. You get your own.
I don't get to play with her.
No, you don't. Well, you'll have to wait until you open them up and see. But anyway, we really appreciate you guys for all that you're doing, and we know you've gone through difficult times lately, and we thank you so much for coming and all that good stuff, and I'm not very eloquent at talking, so anyway, here's a card for you, and the pink one goes to Karen, and the green one goes to Vince, there you go, and you can open them up now if you want. Yes, you can.
Yeah.
We want to know what we bought.
If that one's too big for her, I'll have two.
They can be exchanged.
No, if they're not signed.
That's what she says, won't they?
You folks as a congregation never cease to amaze me at how much you love and care for us. And most of all, because it's genuine. There are places in the world today where people show it as a gesture, and it may not have a lot of meaning. But everything from the handshakes to the hugs to the little things that you never forget. I'm just so grateful to be here and to be a part of this group, this congregation that we call our church. Thank you.
You said it all.
And at this time, we'll take up the offering, and all the loose money or the little harvest bags are going to the ladies' mission. Okay, join us as we sing Rosemary's Favorite, I'll Fly Away.
Happening this week that we use pumpkins for? Yeah, right? Well, come on up, guys. You look like you're tired. Were you playing hard? I like Ethan's shirt. If you guys can see it, it says Sundays are for naps. Jesus and nap. Sorry, I missed that line. Boys, that's bad. That's an awesome shirt. Now, do you guys know that you're like a pumpkin? Yeah. You're like a pumpkin. We've got our shell, right? And inside, before we ask Jesus into our heart, what's inside a pumpkin? Is it all nice stuff? No. Exactly. There are good things inside, right? That's like there's good things inside us too when we let Jesus use it. But I put this in plastic because it's gross. But this is all the gluck out of the pumpkin. So that's kind of like what we're like before we let Jesus into our hearts, isn't it? But once we let Jesus in our hearts, Ethan, do you want to help me? When we let Jesus into our hearts, we got to pop the eyes. We need to get the eyes out here. And we, Jesus' light shines. Well, I got two. I guess Vince wants me to use this one because he says this is even brighter. But it's kind of green. But when we ask Jesus in our hearts and we put this on, can you see through? Can you see the light that comes through his eyes and out?
Yeah.
Jesus shines through us, doesn't he? Isn't that cool?
Yeah.
When we ask Jesus in our heart, that's what happens. His love shines all through us. And today, I have one of these for you to take home. I'm going to put this gucky stuff down. It didn't break, Vince. Vince is... Did you hear his... So you're all going to take home one of these little books that you can color. And it's the pumpkin prayer. And it says, Lord, open my mind and fill me with your wisdom and guidance. And then when he scoops out all the yucky stuff, Lord, take out all my fussies and frownies and fill me with your love. And then the eyes, Lord, open my eyes to see all of the beautiful things you have made. Now, forgive me, I didn't make a nose. I'm not very talented at carving pumpkins. Lord, help me to be a sweet, sweet fragrance. Do you know what a fragrance is? A nice smell. A sweet, sweet smell for Jesus. And then our mouth, Lord, help me to always speak your words of love and kindness. And then when we put the light inside, it's, Lord, let me be a light to others, for you have filled me with your light. So you all get to take one of these and make it, okay? So I'm going to ask if you'll hand those ones out. And then...
feed us and cause us. dreamed I went to heaven, and you were there with me. We walked upon the streets of gold, beside the crystal sea. I heard these angels singing, and someone called your name. You turned and saw this young man, and he was smiling as he came. And he said, friend, you may not know me now. And he said, but wait. You used to teach my Sunday school when I was only 8. And every week you would say a prayer before the class would start. One day when you said that prayer, I asked Jesus in my heart. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am a life that was changed. I am so glad you gave. Then another man stood before you. He said, remember the time a missionary came to your church. His pictures made you cry. You didn't have much money, but you gave it anyway. Jesus took the gift you gave, and that's why I'm in heaven today. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am the light that was shed. One by one they came, far as your eyes could see. Each life somehow touched by your generosity. Little things that you had done, sacrifices you made, they were unnoticed on this earth. And I know up in heaven, you're not supposed to cry. But I'm almost sure there were tears in your eyes as Jesus took your hand and you stood before the Lord. He said, my child, look around. Great is your reward. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am a life that was changed. So glad you came. How do you explain? How do you describe a love that goes from east to west and runs as deep as it is wide? You know all our hopes, Lord, you know all our fears. And words could not express the love we feel, but we long for you to hear. So listen to our heart, hear our spirit sing a song of praise that flows from those you have redeemed. And we will use the words we know to tell you what an awesome God are not enough to tell you of our love. Just listen to our hearts. If words could fall like rain from these lips of mine, and if I had 1,000 years, I would still run out of time. So if you listen to my heart, every beat will say, thank you for the light, thank you for the truth, thank you for the way. And listen to our heart,
oh Lord, please listen,
hear our spirit sing. A song of praise that flows from those you have redeemed. And we will use the words we know to tell you what an awesome God you are. But when words are not enough to tell you of our love, just listen to our heart. For the light, thank you for the truth, thank you for the way. And listen to our heart,
oh Lord, please listen,
hear our spirit sing,
hear us sing
a song of praise that flows. Listen to our hearts. When words are not enough to tell you of our love, just listen to our hearts. Listen to our.
As a little of the insight, some of our bygone days. A little insight where the ladies' mission started, known as the WHFMS, the Women's Home Foreign Mission Society. That's quite a name, isn't it? But it became later as the ladies' mission, as you know us. In September 1977, Pauline Nickerson became the first president, a vision of Dean Cunningham's. 1 year later, Joanne Newell became the second president. And when the calendar turns to 2019, it will be my 40 years for being the third president. I give God the praise and a big thank you to you, to all the ladies of past and present. We was a group of old and young willing to do God's work. We remain the same today, inviting any ladies of age 18 and up to come join. We are not a group of entertainment or to be entertained, but a group of God's business, a devotion for encouragement, a prayer time, and a snack for social time. Our purpose is the same today as it was from the start, to reach people in love for salvation. Each year varies for needs. Projects for 2017 and October to 2018 includes providing fresh refreshments following the 2017 fisherman service. Prayer mugs were exchanged among the members. Financial support was given for families during the Christmas season. Memorial Angels for fundraiser. Sponsored a World Vision Child. Food outreach was provided for several families. Meals were supplied to surgery patients. Financial support was given to people traveling for medical reasons. To school lunches in high school, served as the social committee for the church. Each month we visited elderly and shut in 1 hour before our regular meetings, catering to various receptions, helped provide the breakfast for the Easter sunrise service, provided a ladies' bruncheon inviting ladies from all island churches, as well as Bear Point and Woods Harbor. We knit newborn hats, and that goes to the IWK. Had a booth at the Canada Day celebration selling home baked goods in 1 to 2 person serving sizes. Provided individual bagged baked goods to the congregation on the fall harvest service. And the upcoming projects includes the Samaritan Purse shoe boxes, social following the fisherman service, supporting for families during the Christmas season. The ladies' mission meet the third Tuesday of each month with a total of 11 members. During our January 2018 meeting, the following officers were elected: President Lynne Atkinson, Vice President Kathleen Nickerson Ayers, Secretary Marcia Gooden, and Treasurer Diane Boyd. We would like to say a special thank you to the people in the church who support us in any way, whether it be financial support to a response to requests for food, for receptions, or food outreach. A little statement here from Warren Wiersbe. It says, all of God's people are missionaries. Not missionaries, I think of missionaries, are ministers. A few are ministers with a capital M. We are either good ministers or bad ministers, but ministers we are. And as a minister, we should be judged. We will be judged by the Lord on the last days. What are God's servants but his tools, who must inspire the hearts of men and women and stir them to spiritual joy? And at this time, Diane's going to come sing us a song. Anybody that would like to have a video of the pictures, a remembrance, Steve will do one off for you, if anybody just ask him. Okay, let's go in prayer. Our dear Heavenly Father, we do thank you that we could come here today and join our hearts, Lord, in bygone days. Lord, you have blessed our group, and you have blessed our church. Even though, Lord, sometimes we have a heavy heart to think about the bygone days. Of many that has passed on and some have moved on, Lord. But you have blessed each woman that has represented Our Lady's mission over the years. And we just thank you for Dean having that mission, a vision for our mission group. And that you have carried us all these years, Lord, of doing for people. People that we don't even know, some of them, who they are, Lord. They've never met us, we've never met them. But you do know who they are, Lord. You know the needs, O Lord, in our communities. You've laid the burdens upon our heart for many people as we have prayed over the years for many situations. And we just want to thank you for that, Lord. And you have brought us together, Lord, as sisters in Christ. And we thank you for that too, Lord. We have many, many things to thank you for, Lord. And Lord, as we start going into a new year, we might be small in number, Lord, but where there's two or three, you are amid us, Lord. And we will continue doing your work, what you want us to do. So, Lord, we just pray that you'll go before us and that we will never become a selfish group, that we will never take the praise for what you have done for us.
and all the things that you accomplished. And we pray for the people that's in our church here today, Lord, that they too and each one of us realize that we need to be that minister, that we need to be a good minister, that we can go out and draw people into our church, and that we are tools for you, Lord, and we thank you for that. We pray for the missionaries that's in the foreign fields, Lord, that how they leave their homes and that they are willing to go and do your work. And we don't have no idea what they go through. But we pray for their safety, O Lord. We pray for their needs. And we know there's many in our own homeland that's starting planting churches, Lord. And it's not an easy thing to do. But Lord, we know it's what you are calling us for. And may each one of us here realize that we are starting to plant churches here right around our own community. So Lord, we just ask, where there is a need, you will provide us by the things that you want us to do. And Lord, we just thank you and praise you for everything. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, at this time, we got our speaker. Oh, I'm sorry, I haven't got my paper here. Emma's going to read scripture and then Karen.
Scripture comes from Luke 10:38-42. As they continued their travel, Jesus entered a village. A woman by the name of Martha welcomed him and made him feel quite at home. She had a sister, Mary, who sat before the Master, hanging on every word he said. But Martha was pulled away by all she had to do in the kitchen. Later, she stepped in, interrupting him. Master, don't you care that my sister has abandoned the kitchen to me? Tell her to lend me a hand. The Master said, Martha, dear Martha, you're fussing far too much and getting yourself worked up over nothing. One thing only is essential, and Mary has chosen it. It's the main course, and it won't be taken from her. It's the word of the Lord.
I'd like to say welcome to all our online viewers as well as those who are gathered in here today. The scripture that Emma read today was taken from the Message. And I thought it was appropriate that we read from the Message today because the man who translated the Message, Eugene Peterson, passed away this week. So I thought it was so fitting that we use a modern translation for today's service. Let's just bow our heads and pray before we start. Father, thank you that we can come here together today and celebrate all the work that you're doing in this church through the ladies' mission. Lord, we pray that more will come out and join us. And we just pray, Lord, that you will bless this, your word. You will bless the words I speak and help us to put the words that you give us into action in our lives and in our hearts. And we ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen. So Luke 10:38-42. It's a scripture that we heard. It's an account of two very different sisters. Have you ever noticed how children in the same family can be polar opposites of each other in personality? Now, growing up in my house, I was the middle child. My brother was the eldest. He was 8 years old when I came along. The poor guy was an introvert. He loved to read, to build models. He loved to write stories, talented artist, and he had a brilliant sense of humor, but he was very quiet. And then along came Miss Chatty. I can still remember my brother on my first day of school. He was in grade 9, and I was in grade 1. The schools were connected. Elementary was on this side, and then junior high was on the other side, and it was his last year of junior high. And you have to understand, I was about this high, and my brother would have been almost 6 feet tall at that point. So my first day of school, I'm so excited, and Mom had sent us off with a very stern warning that I
hold his hand. I listened to my brother, and I was so proud to be holding my big brother's hand and walking to school. So I'm skipping along so proud, and I'm chatting a mile a minute. And as soon as we're out of sight of the house, he drops my hand like a hot potato. And I mean, my six-year-old logic, I'm standing there and I'm going, "You have to hold my hand, Mom said." And he just rolls his eyes and just, "No." So anyway, he refused to hold my hand. And I kept my complaints up the whole way along the street. But he was good. At intersections, he'd take my hand and make sure I got across safely and watch both ways and all that stuff. But as soon as we were across the street and on the sidewalk, his hands went back in his pockets again. So he's delivering me to my side of the elementary school, and he's going on to the junior high. And I was just, of course, talking. I don't know. I mean, I'm over that now. But I was talking and talking and talking. And he finally turns to me before we get to the school, and he says, "Do you ever shut up?" To which I replied, "No," and continued on. So that was my brother and I. Then we had a younger sister, and she too was an introvert. I don't know where they came from. She played with dolls, and she played grocery store while I was out playing softball with the neighborhood kids. We were so different, the three of us. Different personalities, different interests. But Mary and Martha were like that too. Mary was a listener. She was sitting listening to this wonderful teacher who has come to visit their home. And Martha, on the other hand, is so busy in the kitchen trying to micromanage the fine details of providing a meal for their special guest that she ignores him. Mary is, at that time, you know, in that point, Mary is doing what the men were doing. Women didn't take part in the Bible studies. Women didn't serve like our ladies serve today. Women were busy doing the busy work, and they were looking after the men. But they never got to sit and listen. And Mary recognized that Jesus was who he was. And she sat and listened. She was a brave lady. Now, Martha's so disgruntled with her sister. I mean, you can imagine if she's so disgruntled that she goes out to Jesus. And, you know, she's saying, like, "Why is she doing here? You know, just sitting here when I'm out doing all the work. Shouldn't she be helping her, helping me?" Imagine how she felt when Jesus tells her that Mary's doing the right thing. How many times, and this goes for the guys too, how many times have you been upset with your spouse because they're not doing what you want them to do? I won't answer. And I'm also not going to answer how many times, those times that I was ticked off, they really didn't matter anyway. So my question today is, are you a Mary or are you a Martha? And before we answer, let's look at both ladies. Martha is busy working in the kitchen, and while it seems that everyone else in the house is listening to the guest as he speaks to them. Now, I think Mary recognizes that Jesus is very special, and she wants to soak in everything. But Martha is so busy that she's ignoring him. Have you ever been so busy doing ministry that you forgot to spend time with Jesus? I have. A few years ago, we were part of a very large church. I love being involved in the ministries. I was the church pianist, the choir pianist, the junior choir director, the Sunday school superintendent. I was a teacher. I was involved in ladies' ministries, special events, and the list goes on. I had a beautiful little girl. We were raising her in church. I had a wonderful husband. And yeah, that was Vince. He was working full-time and going to Bible school part-time.
and we were a very busy ministry family. It was coming up on Father's Day, and the kids' choir was getting ready to do a musical called Sermon on the Mount. Olivia was part of the choir, and if I'm remembering correctly, we had about 20 kids and a few adults who were singing and acting in the production, and it was a major production. I was sewing costumes, building sets, corralling kids, making sure that they knew their lines, making sure that they knew the music, and that they were singing out loud. And then suddenly I found myself flat on my back. I wasn't taking care of me. I ended up in recovery with a major concussion and not able to do all the things that were in my daytime or coming up for this production. I had to rely on others to run rehearsals. And I was, Vince is laughing because he was one of them. And then I was only able to be there that night long enough for the production and leave. I remember the look on my neurologist's face as he looked at me and said, "Karen, you have a beautiful little girl and you have a good husband. Don't throw it away. Take care of yourself. They need you. Smarten up." As I look back, I think, like Martha, I needed to be busy and feel needed. And as I recovered, the words of Psalm 46:10 kept echoing over again and again in my mind. "Be still and know that I am God." Yes, the things that I was doing, they were wonderful things. They were all ministry things. But I didn't need to be doing it all by myself. I was so busy taking care of everyone else, I wasn't taking care of me. And I wasn't taking time with my devotions. I wasn't taking time with Olivia with her devotions that night. I was just rushing through them. And then I was crashing into bed and starting all over again the same way the next day. But Mary had the right idea. She spent time at the feet of the Master. She listened to his words that would give her encouragement, solace, and comfort. Psalm 1, verses 1 to 3 says, "Blessed is the one who doesn't walk in the step of the wicked, or stand in the way that sinners take, or sit in the company of mockers. But they delight in the law of the Lord and meditate on his law day and night. That person is like a tree planted by streams of water, which yields fruit in season, and whose leaf doesn't wither. Whatever they do prospers." Now please understand, I am not telling you to give up every ministry position that you hold in the church. But I am encouraging you to take time every day with the source of our strength. Spending time with God will revive your tired soul. Be a Mary, not a Martha. Last week, Olivia gave the eulogy at my mom's funeral. And she recalled staying over at mom and dad's on different occasions and seeing them sitting in the evening, reading their Bibles together, and mom journaling her thoughts from the day. Maybe bedtime is a good time for you to do your devotions, that you can spend more time with God that way and more quality time. Or maybe you're a morning person and your coffee and your Bible is your best friend to start the day. Whatever the best time of day is, it doesn't matter. The most important thing is that, like Mary, you spend quality time with the teacher. We're coming up to our busiest season here, and I have no idea how busy you guys are going to get. Lobster season is starting soon, and I hear just to stay off the roads during those times when everybody's getting ready for dumping day. Just get out of the way. As families, you're going to be crazy busy. And then on top of that is Christmas. Life gets busy. But let's make sure that during this crazy time, we take the time to stay connected with God first and with each other second. Let's not lose sight of the source of our strength. We live in an age of communication, but we don't have to wait for a cell tower or internet to be connected to God. All we have to do is call on his name, and he will answer. So my challenge to you today is to be a Mary and sit with the Master. Can we pray? Father, thank you for each one that is here today. Thank you for those who have gone before us in Ladies' Mission. Lord, we just pray that you will touch hearts today to step out in ministry. Lord, those who are in ministry now, we pray that you will touch their hearts and encourage them and strengthen them and bless them. We thank you for each one here in this church. And now, Lord, we pray that you will go with us and help us to determine individually to spend time with you. Let us gather close to you and learn all that we can and to draw on your strength. We ask these things in your name. Amen. Did you want to close? Okay. You're allowed to close.
Thank you, Karen. That's a wonderful reminder and a wonderful call from the scripture for us to be a Mary and not a Martha, to choose the things that are most important as we follow the Master. As we close in prayer, do I get to announce? I was going to keep the doors open. Somebody closed them. Can you imagine the temptation I had knowing what's on the table out there with the doors closed? I didn't even have to preach. I could have snuck out early and made off with, there's a table full of goodies out there. And is there a plate for each person?
A bag
with a nice bunch of goodies inside. You get to choose some goodies to take home for a snack. And that's just a blessing from our Ladies' Mission. And I'm going to close in prayer. Can we stand together? And we'll thank God for the ladies that get involved in ministry. I was told to learn to behave when I got here that the ladies ran the church. And I said, great. And they looked at me and I said, the ladies are getting it right. Now, men, my challenge to you over the next year, I already have two incredible speakers who are willing to come here. They're friends of mine. One with an incredible story that, guys, you're just going to be thrilled to hear. Another guy with a challenge of things that we can do in ministry. He's been involved in missions teams around the world. He's also a lobster fisherman from this end of the country. And I'm pleased to say I've been connected to family of his and got to network with him the other day. I also networked with a lady that wants to come to your Ladies' Mission as a speaker to challenge the ladies to be involved in a ministry that she's a part of. So had a great last couple of weeks and really looking forward to the Believability Tour and how the ladies and men of this church can get involved in ministry. Let's close in prayer. Father God, I thank you for today. I thank you for women that will step forward in ministry and will be a part of your hands extended to minister to the people who so desperately need it. Help us each in turn to minister and to receive ministry from you as people step forward to minister, just like my heart's been touched today. I pray, Father, that as we continue to work together, that this town, this island, this area, and the world beyond will be touched by the presence of the Holy Spirit that works through us. Go with us now. May your blessing, presence, and peace be with us. May your guiding hand direct us this week, and may it be all for your glory. In Jesus' name, amen.